friends, Heidi here from Rain Country. God is good all the time. And I'm here to talk more about some of my favorite secondhand finds. Now, I have lots and lots and lots of favorite secondhand finds. So this could be a series that goes on forever. But if you didn't see my last video, it was in collaboration with Mary from Mary's Nest, and a few others decided to jump in. And if you want to jump in, let us know. Make your video and we'll add you in. I will link to that playlist right up here in the corner. Now let me get started on what I've got out here today. So in my last video, I was actually broken up into three categories. And one of the categories in there was oil lamps. And oil lamps, most of the ones I have found at garage sales for a dollar or less. And I think I might have paid $3 for one, but typically a dollar or less is what I pay for them. Same thing with candles. I find tons of candles. These candles I'm going to show you right here in no way represent even half of the great candles I have found. Now, one of the things we do with candles that we find at garage sales and such, we stock up on them, we melt them down. The ones that we don't want to use for lighting purposes, we melt down and turn them into fire starters. And we have a video on that I'll link to right up here. But let me show you all these. Every single candle that you see here, I paid a dollar for, just $1 each. And none of them had been used before I got them. So any use you see on these candles were used that I put on them myself. So inside here, this candle, this is actually a party light candle I paid a dollar for. This was a separate, it was at the same garage sale, but it was separate, it was in a different place. I paid a dollar for this as well. This was also party light. Neither one of these had ever been used. This one came with this, $1. Same thing here, this candle came with this stand. All I cared about was the candles, but they were getting rid of the stands too. So I was like, yeah, I'll take it. I mean, if they're going to give it away. And then this set of three candles right here, I paid a dollar each for, same garage sale. And then they each came with their own little plate to sit on. And then you can see this candle right here. Look how big this is. These kind of candles, these pillar candles, I love them because they last for a very, very long time. And if you were to buy this brand new, the least you're going to pay in cost for one of these is going to be $10. But you can find candles like this all day long, every garage sale, I swear, for a dollar or less, maybe possibly more, but chances are you could talk them down to a dollar. And then here's another one. This one I think is from the 1970s, actually. You can see it's kind of faded. I like it though for some reason. It's kind of cool. And then the last candle I'm going to show you, this actually wasn't a garage sale find. This was one of the things I found in my mom's house when I was cleaning everything out. And it's a candle holder. I love it. It's got dragonflies and butterflies on it. I'm sure somebody bought this for her as a gift. I don't know who, but, and then inside there, I can't remember how to get into it, but inside there is a nice candle. There's a door here somewhere to open. I think that was right here. But anyway, you can get in there and you can light the candle. So this is going in our rec room that we've been fixing up. And there will be a video coming. It probably won't be too far out because we're getting closer and closer every day. Now, that's it for the candles. But with that topic about the rec room, another secondhand find we just got, and I set this here because I couldn't bring the whole thing in, was a nice foosball table. If you're looking for recreational items for your whatever, like we're doing here, don't buy brand new, ever. You can find foosball tables and pool tables all the time secondhand, and you're going to be way better off if you're wanting to just do a little something extra. Find it used, as long as it's in good usable condition, of course. But we started looking for foosball tables in our area. I went to the Facebook market, and right there was a foosball. There was a whole bunch of them. And we still had to drive to go get this one. It was a couple hours away, but it was still a great deal. Another thing I found in my mom's house when I was cleaning out was yet another cast iron skillet, which was funny because I know my mom never used cast iron skillets. This one, the only marking on there says 8-inch skillet. That's all it says. So I don't know what brand this is. It I'm guessing it might be pretty old. It seemed like some of the old ones, they didn't put brand names on them. They just made them and sold them and just marked them by size. Maybe somebody can help me with that who knows more about, you know, old cast iron and all that. But anyway, this, the difference between this one and the other ones I have of this size is this one, I don't know if you can tell, it is much deeper. And so this, I'm thinking I really don't need any more cast iron skillets, especially more of the same size. However, I love this thing because it's the perfect size for making something like meatballs and gravy, where I don't need a huge wide pan, but I want something deeper. And so you can see right here in these pictures, I was cooking the meatballs and then adding the gravy in there. See, my problem always was, you know, when cooking just for the two of us and making something like meatballs and gravy, I didn't want to use a big pan. But then when you go to make the gravy and put it in there, it was just a little bit too much because the pans were too shallow. And so this is perfect for that. So really great, great find there. Had I not been there helping to clean out stuff, it would have just most likely ended up, well, it could have gone to the Goodwill, but knowing some people, they probably would have just tossed it, assuming nobody uses cast iron anymore. Because a lot of people like that nasty Teflon stuff. Okay, and a couple other finds I wanted to talk about was, I talked about this one in another video. This is an old ice crusher, and I can't remember, I think it's 1960s. And I've been actually looking for one of these because when we replaced our old side-by-side, the area that our refrigerator goes in, they keep making refrigerators bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger, and then they don't fit into the areas that, you know, when the house was built, it was meant for to actually have space on one side. And now even the simple refrigerator we got just barely fits in there. And it was, you couldn't find any side-by-sides or the kinds with the two doors in the bottom. It was hard to find anything that would fit in there. So we had to give up our ice crusher. And a lot of times I like to have some crushed ice, and I was okay with that. So I was looking for an old-fashioned ice crusher, vintage one, and that's what I found. And to me, I kind of felt like it was another one of those things where the person probably didn't even know what it was worth. It was their grandmother's. And I paid $1 for this too. And it's green. My favorite color is green. The main color in my kitchen is green, so it's perfect. And then, of course, an old classic ball bale wire jar that I used to store my allspice in. And then a couple other things that were just cool was these little pots had never been used. And they're nice little enamel pots that she was only charging 50 cents a piece for. Brand new, made in Spain, called Megaware. I actually looked it up and it's kind of expensive. But anyway, I use these a lot for dinners for the two of us. I can put vegetables in one. I can put potatoes in another and stick it on our wood stove. And it's that simple. I just cut up some potatoes if I want more of a baked potato and stick them in there. And they're just the right size for the two of us to hold potatoes and vegetables. And so that's what I think it used frequently, 50 cents a piece. And, you know, they come with a lid, so you're not wasting aluminum foil or anything like that for stuff you want to bake. And I love things that come with lids that I can bake, and I don't have to worry about wasting aluminum foil. So anyway, so that's my secondhand finds for today. And go ahead and share below if you've got any really cool, great, interesting secondhand finds. And again, if you want to be a part of the original collaboration, just let me know. If you've made a video, just go ahead and post a comment below with the link to your video, and I'll make sure you get added to the playlist. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Take care, and God bless.